Hi, my name is Manish Gupta and I work at Microsoft. Today I'm going to talk about multitask knowledge distillation for IDC's prediction. This work is in collaboration with Sahil, Vipul and Prashant from Microsoft and with Dr. Rania from Bascom Palmer Institute. These are four different popular eye diseases: glaucoma, diabetes, age-related macular degeneration and uveal melanoma. Melanoma is like cancer of the eye. The interesting part about these diseases is that they show a whole bunch of symptoms in fundus images. So if you can, if you look at these fundus images, doctors can actually figure out this is the disease given the fundus image. There are various kinds of treatments that one can do if you can detect these eye diseases early. But there is a problem. The problem is limited availability of ophthalmologists, lack of awareness and consultation expenses, which basically restrict these early diagnosis. Hence, automated screening is very important. So the question that we want to answer is that can the advances in deep learning be useful to detect these eye diseases automatically from fundus images? We focus on learning deep learning classifiers, but then they require large amounts of labeled data, but our focus is to use small amount of labeled data to be able to detect these eye diseases. Specifically, our problem is to really use small labeled data L and large amount of unlabeled data U to detect these diseases broadly, or even figure out fine-grained sub-diseases out of these four, 320 fine-grained subcategories, or even come up with an automated diagnosis as a doctor would write. This problem is really challenging. There's lack of labeled data. There is, you know, images are very heterogeneous depending on the devices which were used to capture, blur, and so on. There are artifacts due to imaging devices as well. There is a lot of related work which can help us solve this problem, like machine learning for eye care, deep learning for medical imaging, and so on. We leverage two important tools, multitask learning and deep learning with small labeled data, to solve our problem. This is a broad architecture of a proposed method. The input is the image, the output is these three labels. And you know, this, of course, small amount of labeled data that we have and a large amount of unlabeled fundus images. We depend on two main things, multitask learning using these different CNN models, convolutional neural network models, which are learned for individual tasks or a combination of tasks, right? So multitask learning, and also another tool called as knowledge distillation, which sort of helps us learn a small student model from a large teacher model by mimicking the distribution from the teacher model. Now, this is more details about our multitask learning setup. So given the image, you know, we use this ResNet 50, which is a CNN model, so as to come and a few, you know, feed forward layers, so as to come up with the final predictions. Okay. Now, a little more details. So you can take the labeled images and train these kinds of models using labeled data. So we can compute cross entropy loss between the actual labels and the predictions that we come up with. And that's basically learning from the labeled data. But hey, you know, we can also use self-training to improve the accuracy of this basic model that we learn from just labeled data. So this is self-training is a popular semi-supervised learning technique, and we use a better technique called as knowledge distillation, which uses scale divergence loss. So we combine the cross entropy loss between the predictions of M2 model and the labeled data, with the scale divergence distillation loss between M2 and M1, and that gives us better model. Further, we can actually exploit the large amount of unlabeled data that we have so as to define a distillation scale divergence loss between the newly learned model M3 and the teacher model M2. So this gives us really robust results. So here are the results. So before we get into the results, we use data set from 3,502 patients from Bascom Palmer Eye Institute collected over a decade. 7,000 or so labeled images and large amount, 36,000 or so unlabeled images coming from Topcon 50X OIS capture station. So if we just use the basic initial model without any self-training, without any, you know, knowledge distillation and so on, but deploying multitask learning, we observe that multitask learning really gives us a significant boost over just learning these individual classifiers one by one, right? So in fact, we also observe that if we combine multitask learning with knowledge distillation, that gives us much more boost. So, you know, a huge amount of boost across all the three tasks. The boosts are, of course, larger when we have larger amount of labeled data compared to small amount of labeled data for training. And also, you know, the boosts are larger when we combine the three tasks together. In fact, what we observed is that combining the three tasks together with Ensemble gives us better results compared to just using the multitask learning teacher, just the three tasks, right? So these are some visualizations to see, to show, you know, what the convolutional neural network looks at when it is coming up with the prediction. So as you see, we show for different diseases, and also when we actually use both the things, multitask learning as well as noise distillation in our M3 model. With large amount of labeled data set size, about 70%, we observe that the model is really looking at the right parts of the image as compared to the human annotations, as you see here. So in conclusion, you know, we use multitask learning and KD to solve a very important task of diagnosing diseases.